So let's understand how the RC memory model works with a concrete example. So let's say the programmer's intent is that one thread of his program is going to modify a structure A. And there is another thread that is going to wait for the modification, and then it is going to use the structure A. So this is the programmer's intent, right? So P2 is going to wait for the modification, use it, and this guy is the guy that is modifying that particular structure A. And of course, these are running on different processors, and therefore, we don't know who may be getting to their code first. So let's say that P2 executes the code that corresponds to this semantic. That is, it wants to wait for the modification. So in order to do that, it has a flag, and this flag has a semantic that is 0, indicating the modification is not done, and 1, when the modification is actually done. And to make sure that we don't do busy waiting, we use a mutual exclusion lock. We lock a synchronization variable, let's call it L, and if the flag is 0, then it is going to execute the equivalent of a pthread can't wait. You know, pthread can't wait has the semantic that you're waiting on a condition variable, and you're also releasing the lock that is associated with this condition variable. So you execute this pthread wait call, and the semantic you know is that at this point, thread P2 is blocked here, the lock is released, and he's basically waiting for a signal on this condition variable C. Who's going to do that? Well, of course, P1 is the guy that is modifying the structure, so it's the responsibility of P1 to signal him. So let's see what happens. So P1 is executing the code for modifying the data structure A, and once it is done with all the modification, then it is going to inform P2. So in order to inform P2, what it does is it acquires this lock L, and it sets this flag to 1, and the flag is the one that I inspected over here to know that, oh, the modification is not yet done here, and I'm waiting on this condition variable. So P1 sets the flag to 1 and signals on the condition variable C. And you know that signaling on the condition variable is going to wake up P2. And of course, it cannot start executing here until P1 has released the lock. And once the lock has been released, that lock will be acquired implicitly by the operating system on behalf of P2, because that is the semantic of this conditional wait here. So when I wake up, I'll go back, and as a defensive mechanism, I'll recheck the flag to ensure that the flag is now not zero, indicating that the modification has been done. So I am now ready to get out of this critical section. I unlock L, come out of the critical section. Now I can use this modified data structure. So that's the semantic that I wanted, and I got that with this code fragment that I'm showing you here. So the important thing is, if we have an RC memory model, then all the modifications that I'm making here, that is modifying shared data structures, can go on in parallel with all this waiting that may be going on here. I don't have to block the processor to do every one of these modifications. The only point at which I have to make sure that these modifications have been made globally visible is when I hit the unlock point in my code. So just before I unlock L, I have to make sure that all the read-write accesses to shared variables that I made here in my program have all been taken care of in terms of the coherence actions being communicated to all my peers. Only then I have to unlock it. So in other words, this code fragment is giving you pictorially the opportunity for exploiting computation in parallel with communication. If the model was an SC memory model, then for every read-write accesses that are being done in modifying the data structure A, there would have been coherence actions that would have gone on, and those coherence actions, each of them has to complete before you can do the next one and so on. But with the RC memory model, what it is allowing you to do is you can do the data structure modification you want, and the coherence actions inherent in those modifications may be going on in the background, but you can continue with your computation until you hit this unlock point. At this point, The memory model will ensure that all the coherence actions are complete before releasing the lock, because once the lock is released, this guy is going to get it and immediately it'll start using the data structure that has been modified by me. So it is important that all the coherence actions be complete prior to unlocking. So that's the intent of the RC memory model, and that's how you can exploit computation going on in parallel with communication if the memory model is an RC memory model.